Hey everyone, welcome back. So today, we're going to be looking at another great list of games that are currently on sale on the Nintendo Switch eShop. And I'm telling you this week, the list is massive. Normally these lists are between 10 to 15 games. This week I upped it all the way to 20 because there are just so many incredible games on sale this week. So if ever I go through the descriptions of the video a little quicker than usual, it's just to keep this video within a reasonable length. There are also a few games on this list that are such classic universal games. I won't go too much into the details of the game, just because I'm pretty sure everyone watching this video already knows what the game is all about. And now, as usual, don't forget to hit the like button if you like what you're seeing. It really does help the video out a lot. And at the same time, why not subscribe to the channel if you aren't already? Now, the first game that we're going to take a look at is one of those games that I think needs no introduction. It is the remaster of Final Fantasy VII. Currently, it's at 50% off for only $7.99. Now, this is one of the classic RPGs that put the PS1 on the map back in the day. If you've never played it and you want to try out a Final Fantasy game, this is probably the best starting point you can have overall, because the storylines don't follow each other. Now, this is not the remake that you're hearing about that are available on the other systems. This is a remaster of the original Final Fantasy VII that came out on the PS1. Now, the second game on my list has actually been featured quite a few times on these lists, and that is Dragon Ball FighterZ. And basically, right now, not only is the base game on sale for $9.59, so if you want a really cheap way to get into the game and just try it out, this is an okay pack, but the best sale right now is on the Ultimate Edition, which gets you a bunch of downloadable characters, some extra song packs and whatnot, and that one is only $17 approximately. It is on sale as well. We're probably not going to look at it separately in this video, but just to let you know, it is available. And on top of that, if you want the extra DLC packs for the other characters, they're all 50% off now as well. So if you wanted to get into Dragon Ball FighterZ, this is an excellent time. The deal isn't as sweet as it was last week when the FighterZ edition was on sale, but nonetheless, this is still an uber cheap way to get into this game and get a bunch of DLC. Now, the next game on the list probably doesn't need any introduction either. It is Final Fantasy VIII. Once again, another incredible original Final Fantasy game from the PlayStation 1. However, I would say not quite as epic as Final Fantasy VII was, but if you have played Final Fantasy VII and you haven't had a chance to play the VIII, this is an incredible remaster, and it is once again a very strong RPG all around. However, if you are never played the Final Fantasy series, I would not recommend starting with this one. This is a good one to play once you've actually gotten into the whole Final Fantasy universe. Next, we have an awesome game that I was actually waiting quite a while to come to the Switch, and that was Jurassic World Evolution, the Complete Edition. Now, this is a park builder. So if you're into strategy park building, it is an incredible game. And what I love the most about the Nintendo Switch Edition is often park builders, the control schemes and the overall controls of the game are really not that good when you're trying to play with a controller on a console, but this isn't the case for Jurassic World Evolution. The control scheme works very, very well, and at 35% off with this game coming out only, I would say, a month ago, it is an excellent time to pick it up at $38.99. On top of it, it comes with all the DLC that came out over time in the Complete Edition. This is just an amazing pack if you're into park building. This is a great one, and with the Jurassic Park franchise, it was very well implemented. Now, next on our list, once again, one of those games that I'm not sure needs an introduction, we have Final Fantasy IX. Now, this is my second overall favorite from the PlayStation 1 era in the main series of Final Fantasy, because don't get me started on Final Fantasy Tactics, I love that game to death. But if we're talking about Final Fantasy IX now, this is another great RPG. However, it's done in a more retro style, more classic to the original Final Fantasies than 7 and 8 were, but it nonetheless is a very strong RPG on its own. So if you want to try out something really solid at $10.49, 50% off once again, this is another great installment in the Final Fantasy franchise. And I would say, like I said, the second best overall in the main series that was available on the PS1 era. Now, next on our list, we have Katamari Damacy Reroll. Once again, this isn't the first time this game is on the list. This is a really incredible laid-back puzzler, and at only $9.89, which is 67% off, it's a great time to pick it up. Basically, you have to roll giant balls to create planets. And how do you do that? Well, you roll them around the stage, picking up objects, and once they're big enough, you basically can pass on to the next stage. It's an incredibly addictive gameplay. Try it out. It's an awesome game. Next, we have probably one of the best overall Roguevanias available on the Nintendo Switch, which is Dead Cells. And right now it's 40% off at $14.99, which is an excellent price to pick it up at. And if you want a very challenging 2D platformer in the Roguevania style, this is an excellent time to pick up Dead Cells. And I'm going to tell you, if you buy this game, you're going to have quite a bit of gameplay in front of you. So for $14.99, you're probably going to easily have over 30 hours of gameplay. And even at that, you have to be pretty used to the genre to be able to finish it in that time frame. Now the next game on the list I might get a little bit of heat for, and that is Bloodstained Ritual of the Night. It is 60% off at $15.99. Now, when this game was released, it was blasted for the Nintendo Switch because it had a ton of bugs, including a really severe input delay. But I've got to tell you, since its release, the game has been seriously patched. I own it myself physically, and I can promise you that right now, most of all the glitches, and especially the input delay, is no longer an issue in Bloodstained. There are small glitches like in any massive Metroidvania like this, but at the same time, it is an incredible experience, and I'm really glad overall that I did purchase the game physically when it came out, because once it got patched, I loved playing through this one. Now, next on our list, I'm actually breaking one of my rules. Normally, when I include a game in last week's video, I don't talk about it again in this week's video, but for Monster Boy and the Cursed Kingdom, I'm making an exception. This game is still 63% off, and it's probably one of the overall best 2D platformers on the Nintendo Switch. Now, this one doesn't have the level of difficulty that Dead Cells had previously. However, it's still a challenging experience, but what overall is just great is that the gameplay is extremely polished, the concept is awesome. You basically play a character who can morph into different animals, giving him different abilities to approach different obstacles. And seriously, if you want just a really solid 2D platformer that will give you an incredible experience for $14.79, Monster Boy is an excellent purchase. And still this week, it is my favorite overall purchase. If you have one game to buy, I would buy Monster Boy in the Cursed Kingdom. Next on the list, we have Tales of Vesperia. The Tales saga is a classic JRPG series. Tales of Vesperia is maybe not, I would say, the best entry, but it's still one of the solid entries in the Tales series. And the reason it's on this list is because it's $12.49. At 75% off, you are getting incredible value for your money. At full price, I would have said there are better JRPGs to put $50 on, but at $12.49, this is a game that I would definitely pick up, even if you have to put it in your backlog, because eventually at this price, I don't really see it getting much cheaper than this, you know, ever again. Now, the next games, I'm actually giving a quick shout out because I'm actually not recommending buying them. And that is the combo pack of Final Fantasy X and X2 at $24.99. And it's not because these games aren't great. They are great games, don't get me wrong. The reason I'm recommending you not buy them is because I already know that physically, they're probably going to be available, once again, cheaper on Boxing Day, probably around the $15 mark for the exact same combination pack. So just don't pay $10 extra for nothing. And this will be the same story when we hit Final Fantasy XII. Final Fantasy XII is a great game, but I know that physically on Boxing Day, it's going to be cheaper than it's being sold right now on the eShop, even with the promotions that are on right now. Now, the next game on the series, once again, I don't think it's going to be needing much of an introduction, but that is Crypt of the NecroDancer. Crypt of the NecroDancer is basically a rhythm-based game, but it is done in an RPG adventuring style, sort of like a Zelda style. Now, I'm going to tell you honestly, this game is one of the best RPG adventure games, even if you don't like normally rhythm-based games, still give Crypt of the NecroDancer a shot. And at 80% off for only $3.99, I would say take the chance if you haven't yet. Nintendo loved this game so much that they had them do a Zelda version of it. Now, the next game on our list is another JRPG, and that is Ni No Kuni, which is honestly one of the surprise greatest JRPGs I've played. I'll be honest with you, at first, the aesthetic of the game didn't attract me because I thought it looked more like a game for young kids. And although the setting at the beginning is very childish, by the end of the game, the setting gets much, much more serious, and this becomes a full-fledged, really fleshed-out, awesome JRPG. So if Ni No Kuni, you haven't played it yet because you found the art style to be looking too childish, trust me, this is a great one. And you can look at the reviews online. It is overall just an awesome RPG to try out. Now, the next game on the list was actually suggested to me by a viewer, and I thank her very much. I tried it out this week, and this is a great game, Blossom Tales, The Sleeping King. This is basically the closest thing you're gonna get to a 2D top-down Zelda game, not called Zelda. And it is a great experience. The game is a little bit short, but at $5.24, it feels like great value. And it's at 65% off, which is why this is such an awesome pickup this week. Like, even at the full price, I would still say this game is worth it. So at $5.24, it's an excellent pickup. And like I said, just it's a Zelda game sort of in between the SNES and NES Zelda. It's more complete than the NES version, but the graphics aren't as polished as what we got on the NES era. Now, the next game on our list is another Final Fantasy game, but that's because a lot of great ones are on sale this week. But like I told you, I'm telling you which ones you shouldn't pick up as well. But Final Fantasy Chronicles at only $20.99, which is 30% off for a game that actually just came out, I would say about 3-4 months ago. It's an excellent pickup. Now, this one is from the GameCube era, so expect quite a higher level of overall graphics polish. But what's great about Final Fantasy Chronicles is it's a game you can actually play in multiplayer. And it's actually a really it's a game that's actually better played multiplayer than single player, but it is an awesome overall experience. It is a great game. However, it's a little bit more simplistic as a storyline. So don't expect such a deep storyline as what you got in like Final Fantasy 7, 8, or 9. But the gameplay seriously makes up for it in a action RPG style. Now, the next game I want to talk about is actually a game pack, and that is the Naruto Shippuden Ultimate Ninja Storm Trilogy. This is the first three Naruto games in one pack for only $20. And I'd actually talked about it in a previous video. The reason I sometimes don't include the Ultimate Ninja Storms when they're on sale is because I know this pack exists, and when this pack goes on sale, it's always way cheaper than buying them all separately. Now, this is the ultimate game pack for a fan of Naruto. If you want to experience all your way through the storyline in an action setting, this is an awesome pack. If you don't know who Naruto is, or you're not a fan of anime in general, just forget about this game, because this is really a fan service game and you have to know Naruto and love it to really appreciate it. But if you are a fan, pick this pack up. At $20 for all three games, it's a great, great value. Now, the next game I'm including on the list is Digimon Cyber Sleuth. Once again, this is a game tailored for fans of Digimon, but it is actually a better experience than I thought it was going to be. I really waited on purchasing this game for a long time because I really didn't like the previous installments of the Digimon series on different gaming consoles, so I sort of had lost faith in getting a good one, and I put this game aside. But when I actually tried it out, this game surprised me, and it really, really is probably the best Digimon game to come out in the last few years. And if the series continues in this direction, this isn't a perfect game, but if it continues in this direction, they can really make something out of the whole Digimon universe on the gaming platforms, at least for North American audiences. I know there's games that were released in Japan that we didn't get here that are actually quite decent, but for the North American audience, this is one of the best Digimon experiences. So if you were a fan back in the day and you want to go back into this world, great time to pick it up. And at 50% off for $24.99, it's a game that came out just this year. It's a great time to pick it up. Just before we move on, shout out, here is Final Fantasy 12. Like I said, it's not that it's a bad game at $24.99. I just know that the physical versions will be cheaper at some retailers for Boxing Day. So if you're in a region that won't have a problem on going to pick up a physical copy or just ordering one online with free shipping, hold out, buy it physically. You're probably gonna get it cheaper than $24.99. Now, you know I can't go without including at least a few really, really good indie games. And the first one is one of my overall favorite twin stick shooters, Blazing Beaks. And right now it's 86% off at only $1.99. Once again, value-wise this week, this is probably the best value game on the whole list this week. If you want a game that is uber cheap, offer you hours of gameplay and really, really fun gameplay, pick up Blazing Beaks. It is an awesome experience. Even at $15 when I bought it, like when it came out, I found it was a great game. So imagine what I think about the value at $1.99. This is a great game to pick up. So I know the list this week is RPG heavy, but the eShop is often like that. They go on bends where right now it's RPGs, action RPGs are the massive games that are on sale. And here we have another one of the best releases on the Switch, I would say overall for a JRPG, which is Star Ocean First Departure. Star Ocean series really needed an installment on the Switch, and we got a really good one in Star Ocean First Departure. This is basically a full remake of the first game, and it is a great remake. It's done in a 16-bit, or I would say early PlayStation 1 style, but it is really, really overall a great installment. And if you want a really seriously long, fully fleshed JRPG, Star Ocean is another great one that's available for this week. It's not my top pick, but it's nonetheless a great one. The next two aren't official entries on the list, but I'm just going to give a quick shout out to BioShock Collection, still available for 2 days. So if you watch this video just as it releases, for $29.99 for the BioShock Collection, really great value. I featured it in a previous video. It just didn't make the cut of the top 20 this week, but it was very close. So that's why I'm giving it a shout out. Same thing for God Eater 3. It's not one of my favorite games on the Switch, but at $15 for the experience, that's what's making it worth it. 75% off. If you want to give God Eater 3 a chance, it's a great time to pick it up at the value. But like I said, there are better games on the list. That's why it didn't make the cut of the top 20 this week. But nonetheless, I just wanted to give them a shout out really quick. By the way, also, Trials of Mana is on sale, but for the same reason as the Final Fantasy XX2 and Final Fantasy 12 collections, I do think that physically this game will be available for cheaper. You can take the plunge at $30. This is still a very good pickup, but I would wait on this one because I do think physical versions are going to be available for cheaper than that at Boxing Day. The next game, however, I would say that you could pick up because I think you might get matched this price, but I don't think it'll be any cheaper for Boxing Day, is Collection of Mana, which is basically the remaster of the Game Boy versions of, once again, the Mana series. And honestly, these games overall, value-wise for $19.99, you also get a remaster of the Super Nintendo version. This is an excellent value. Basically, this package, the reason I prefer to Trials of Mana is just because you're getting three different games for $20, and they're all great games overall. Now, these are retro-styled games, so you have to like that, but once again, like I said, value-wise, you're getting three excellent games for $20, which is, in my opinion, very good value. Now we get to the next and final game on our list, which is Aragami Shadow Edition. Now, in my opinion, Aragami is an underrated game for the Switch. I love this game, I bought it full price, so at 60% off for $11.99, this is a great deal. This is an action game that revolves around stealth kills. It reminds me a lot of the Tenchu series, however, with obviously modernized graphics done in cell shading, and with a mystical twist to it, because you do have these shadow magical abilities that help you out throughout the game. But if you want a great stealth-based game, Aragami, in my opinion, like I said, was underrated for the Switch, and it is a great overall pickup. So for those of you who stuck with me till the end, that was this week's list. And like I said, it was massive, but I'll be honest with you, the reason the list got so massive is that I had more than 40 games on the list, and I had to cut it down to 20. There was no way I was hitting 15. Now I want to throw out a challenge. If you'd like me to do a second video right away this week, like within the next 2 days, looking at most of the other games that were close to making the list but didn't make it, if this video can get 2,000 views within the next 2 days, with at least 100 likes, I will right away make a second video on Monday, a special edition of eShop Deals with all the other games that didn't make the official list. So anyway, I'm throwing out the challenge. Let me know if you want to see that video. If so, just get those views, drop those likes, and we'll do it. And at the same time, just a reminder, if you do like the content, please do subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell so you know when all my videos come out. And as usual, I hope I'll see all of you in my next video.